look at Cooper.
This is Cooper.
This is Cooper.
And this is a training device. This is peanut butter in a little training device. But, oh, my gosh, this is just so much fun.
He loves it.
Oh, my, he loves
it. Great idea.
Come on, Cooper. Okay.
All right, we've got several questions. Sure. We'll get to the first one. I have a 16-year-old cat who has had weight issues ever since she got fixed. In the past week, she's vomited 4 times. Any idea what's wrong?
Okay, so first of all, the weight issue, they can't open their refrigerator. They can't open the can of food. You have to put a cat on a diet, which is very simple for me to say, next impossible to do, because when you put a cat on a diet, they start to bug you. They jump on your face at night. They meow. They cry. But you got to do it. You kind of got to do it. And as far as the vomiting is concerned, you know, if it just happened in the last week, you have to think that it's something
unrelated.
Yeah, to the fatness particularly.
Okay.
But, you know, if it continues, they obviously want to investigate.
All right. All about discipline, though.
Yeah.
Okay. I have a female Chihuahua Terrier mix who is about the size and weight of your standard house cat. Would it be okay for her to breed with a slightly larger male dog?
You remember Red Fox?
Yes.
Red Fox, the comedian. Pardon me.
Sanford and Sons.
Sanford and Fun's Sons. Yeah, he used to have a joke about the ooh-ah bird. It was a 2-inch bird that laid a 9-inch egg. And it would go, ooh-ah. That's what I think about with a small Chihuahua on a bigger dog. I think that it's very dangerous, and you have to be really, really, really careful. Really careful.
All right.
Because, you know, obviously the pelvic outlet is small in these dogs, and some of these big other dogs' heads can't fit through, so you have to do surgery.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank
ooh-ah
you so
bird.
Much. Let's get to the third question. I have a German Shepherd in lab mix. He's around 13 years old and has bad hips and asthma. Last night, he went outside into the cold air and he was gasping for air. How can I help him?
Bad hips. Perhaps that's the reason that there was some pain-induced, you know, some pain-induced anxiety, and that caused some of the dyspnea. But, you know, if your dog has asthma, it has to be checked out. There are things to do to treat these animals that are very effective. But you've got to diagnose it. Got to determine whether you have asthma, or maybe there's a mass in the lungs, or congestive heart failure, or even heartworms.
Okay.
And once you've figured out what the cause is, you treat it symptomatically.
Go to your vet.
Go to your vet.
Thank you, Dr. Kim.
All right.
Thanks, Cooper.
Coop.
Look how great he was. So well behaved.